I feel an immense sense of pride, starting from where we originally conceived this idea and design through to its completion. It's true to that original philosophy of creativity and technology, and the vibrancy and the collaborative nature of the spaces all have come through in this building. The new form of education we're trying to deliver here is very much students working on collaborative skills, on soft skills, on communication, on things that are just outside the normal learning of the discipline. And this building does this magnificently. It sends a message to students that the educational experience is all about them. This building is for students.
Having an actual home now is going to be really great, so having specialised areas exclusively for Faculty of Engineering and IT will be fantastic. Meeting all my fellow engineering friends all in one place rather than, you know, going across campus. I think the new collaborative areas and all the study areas we've got in this new building will, you know, benefit me greatly, because today, especially in engineering, you're not working on your own, you're always working in a group. And having these skills, building these skills at university, will really prepare me for my future career in wherever I go. I've already found my new favourite space, and there's a nice little beanbag by the window with a great view. Just to sit there and chill, have a break, you know, and maybe take a quick nap before anyone sees.
The opportunities we have with moving into this new building is to change the learning experience that students have, and making that learning experience much more a chance to develop the types of skills that they will need to be the leaders in the professions in the future. The way this collaborative theatre is set up means that I can walk in between the rows, I can talk to the students. I'm not going to be stuck out the front in this theatre. I'm going to be in amongst the students. One of the other aspects that I'm really excited about with this building is that we're going to be able to collect real-time data about the building. The whole building has become a real-life lab for students and for staff.
The term living building or living lab arose from the technology that was installed during the construction of the building. We're monitoring the amount of power that the building generates for its own use, its rainwater collection. So the building we see as a living being. It's got the senses that a human being would normally have. The technology that we've incorporated is cutting edge in a lot of respects.
The design of the building, all the collaborative spaces and the kinds of technologies that we have available to us here, like the data arena, that will allow our students to explore the bounds of, you know, what's possible. And, you know, we can only imagine what they're going to come up with, you know, in two or three generations. This building is going to be absolutely humming, you know, full of researchers, students, people doing really interesting things. So the moment you walk in, you're going to feel like you can do anything, right? All the resources are there. You just have to decide what you're going to do, how you're going to change the world, how you're going to actually make a difference.